be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I must confess that that dream that I had that day has in many points turned into a nightmare.
Every tear from the eye. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution. What you say?
My assistant director is from Nigeria. His name is Emmanuel Omizaba, and he has been a great help to me this year. And y'all give him a hand. You'll see his work. You will see his work. His character is Nelson Mandela, and you will see how this man has been such a jewel to us and his talents and being able to assist me with the different cultures and so forth that are done back in South Africa. So please, without further ado, we're going to now present to you Mandela, An Apartheid to Die For.
When Mandela was 8 years old, he was given a new name by his teacher. He was told his new name will be Nelson. As was custom at the time, and probably due to the behest of the British educational system, all African students were given new names. When Mandela was 9 years old, his father, who was chief, passed away. He was adopted by the chief, Jogenta Delalentia, as acting regent of the Thembu people, a gesture done as a favor to Mandela's father. Mandela's father had recommended Jogentaba be chief.
Son, today you begin the process of becoming a man. Not just a man, but a Thembu warrior. From today on, you must fend for yourself, defend your family and land. After today's ceremony, you will take your father's place as a man. Have you packed your bags? Are you ready to go? Your kinsmen are waiting outside to escort you to your sacred grove.
When Mandela was 16, it was time for him to partake in the traditional Thembu circumcision ritual to mark his entrance into manhood. The ceremony was not just a surgical procedure, but an elaborate ritual in preparation for manhood.
Today is the day you join the court of men and our people. You will soon become great warriors of our land. There must be no crying, no fear or weakness of any kind. it was said by our forefathers that an uncircumcised man cannot inherit his father's wealth, even marry, or perform tribal ritual. Since this I said, and today be the day, the ceremony shall now begin.
Traditionally, they return 7 days after the circumcision is done with celebration of their initiation rites into manhood. There is singing, dancing, and celebration. As time passed on, Mandela went to law school at the University of Fort Hare in South Africa, and that is where he met Oliver Tambo. Mandela and Tambo were born in the same town of Transkei. They both joined the African National Congress. Oliver Tambo and Nelson Mandela helped co-found an ANC youth league in which they both rose up quickly in the ranks. Over the years, it became very well respected within the ANC. They both became very important to the ANC, where they were both advocates for South America, for South Africa. In 1956, there was an arrest of 156 ANC members. Later, they were released and given a 5-year band order.
My brothers in the struggle, now that some of our members are locked up and are on trial, and we know that the South African government is planning to arrest all our ANC leaders, we cannot afford for our strong leaders to be locked up. The order has been sent down. We must split them up for the survival of the movement. We were in an executive board meeting earlier in Oliver Tambo. The order has been sent down that you, Oliver Tambo, must leave the country as part of the plan. Mandela, you will go underground.
I don't want to go out of the country because of my family.
Ah, we anticipated such. Therefore, the ANC has made further arrangements for your family to leave the country with you as well.
I have been asked to go underground to ensure the movement continues to move forward. We must do this for South Africa. Amandla!
Amandla!
There was discussion before the Rivonia trial in 1964, where members of the ANC were arrested and accused of high treason.
We are not terrorists, Nelson. You must make them understand. Our people have been suffering for so long in South Africa. There is no way we can avoid the death penalty. But if I must go to the gallows, I will go singing to indicate the determination for our people, freedom in South Africa.
No more. It has to stop. They think that we are killers, but it's them that are killing our families every day.
What do you think? The ANC are terrorists? Spare the nations of people's war fighting the people's army. We fight to liberate our oppressed people. Spare the nations, the sons of our daughters consist of them, the people's oppressed.
But what can we do if we are dead? They want to hang us for treason.
But we are not terrorists. If we are dead, the movement will continue. We must do this for South Africa.
But how do we get them to understand?
I will tell them the truth and pray they listen.
Amandla!
Amandla!
My lord, I am the first accused. I hold a bachelor's degree in arts and practice as an attorney in Johannesburg for a number of years in partnership with Mr. Oliver Tambo, a co-conspirator in this case. I admit immediately that I am a member of the African National Congress and was one of the persons who helped to form Spare of the Nation, in which you refer to as a terrorist group. I played a prominent role in its affairs until I was arrested in August 1962. In my youth in Transkei, I listened to the elders of my tribe telling stories of the old days. Among the tales they related to me were those of war fought by our ancestors in defense of the fatherland. The names of Dingane and Bambata, Hinsta and Mankana were praised as the pride and the glory of the entire African nation. Having said this, I deal immediately at some length with the question of sabotage. Some of the things so far told to the court are true, and some are untrue. I do not, however, deny that I planned the sabotage. I did not plan it in a spirit of recklessness, nor because I have any love for violence. I planned it as a result of a calm and sober assessment of the political situation that had arisen after many years of tyranny, exploitation, and oppression of my people by the whites. But the violence
which we chose to adopt was not terrorism. We who formed Spare of the Nation were all members of the African National Congress and had behind us the ANC tradition of non-violent negotiation as a means of solving political disputes. We believe that South Africa belonged to all the people who lived in it and not to one group, be it black or white. During my lifetime, I have dedicated my life to this struggle of the African people. I have fought against white domination, and I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society in which all persons will live together in harmony and with equal opportunities. It is an ideal for which I hope to live for and to see realized. But my Lord, if need be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
You have been found guilty of sabotage and conspiracy against the state. In the case of accused number one, Nelaon Mandela, the sentence is life imprisonment. Accused number two, Walter Sisulu, life imprisonment. Accused number three, Dennis Goldberg, life imprisonment. Governor Mbeki, life imprisonment. Ahmed Kathabra, life imprisonment. Andrew Mlangeni, life imprisonment. Raymond Mflava, life imprisonment. Elias Motsoaledi, life imprisonment.
The Spirit of Nation believed that as a result of government policies, violence by the African people had become inevitable. The Spirit of Nation also felt that without sabotage, there would be no way open to the African people to succeed in their struggle against the principle of white supremacy.
Here. now. You know how to live, how to live now. Point to somebody, say, you stand. Hallelujah. Clap your hands, everybody.
He was a symbol of a commitment to forgiving his enemies and promoting reconciliation. A man who was cut off from his family and in the end lost a storybook love affair with Winnie Mandela after years of painful incarceration. Nelson was sent to Robben Island in 1964. He spent 18 of his 27 years confined on this prison island. During this time, he wrote a letter to Winnie.
Come, children, come, come. Look, a letter from your father. My dearest Winnie, I have been fairly successful in putting on a mask behind which I have pined for the family. Alone. Never rushing for the post when it comes, until somebody calls out my name.
I also never linger. After visits, although sometimes the urge to do so becomes quite daring. I am struggling to suppress my emotions as I write this letter. I have received only one letter since you were detained. That one dates August 22. I do not know anything about family affairs, such as a payment of rent, telephone bills, care of children and their expenses, whether you will get a job when released. As long as I don't hear from you, I will remain worried and dry like a desert. I recall Cairo. I crossed on several occasions. I saw the desert again in Botswana, on my way to and from Africa, endless beats of sand and not a drop of water. I have not had a letter from you. I feel dry like a desert. Letters from you and the family are like the arrival of summer rains and spring that live in my life and make it enjoyable. Whenever I write you, I feel that inside physical warmth that makes me forget all my problems. I become full of love.
See? He misses us. Who's that?
Townships, locations, reservations, whichever, near the cities of South Africa, where all the black South Africans live. The children shout from the streets as they see police cars coming to raid their homes for one thing or another. They say, "Kauleza mama," which simply means, "Hurry mama, please, please don't let them catch you." Kauleza mama, kauleza mama, kauleza mama, kauleza mama, kauleza mama, sheshi sawo.
Tell me what I want to hear! Tell me what I want to hear! Tell me! Tell me what I want to hear! Tell me! Tell me! These are talking to what? These are talking to what? Let us go!
Nelson, I was forced to grow up on my own. Your formidable shadow, which eclipsed me, left me naked and exposed to the bitter world of a young political widow. I knew what I was walking into, but I said, I do, for better or for worse. Nelson, I knew when I was marrying you, I was marrying the struggle of my people. Nelson, I will never give up the fight I love you, Nelson. And I always will.
Nelson was brought from prison to meet with President F.W. de Klerk to start negotiations for a new South Africa.
Please, sit down. Understand that there will be no promises.
As long as our conversations take us forward.
Well, a good sign of progress would be ending of the arms struggle on your side, a commitment to peace.
Well, for now, my willingness to speak is precisely the commitment to the peace you seek.
Let me put it this way. I need your guarantee.
Excuse me, Mr. President. I will give no guarantee of any kind. I have to talk to my colleagues first.
How can that happen? Most of your people are officially banned and living in exile.
Of course. But if that is an inconvenience, you can always unban the ANC and let our leaders come home so they give you the assurance in person.
That is impossible. At this time.
At this time?
Mr. Mandela, I am yours. Once my government engages in serious negotiations with you, we both know what the ultimate outcome must be.
Free and democratic elections for all people.
I am under no delusions, but I will not accept power grabbing. Power sharing? Yes.
Majority rules is no power grabbing.
No white will ever be comfortable in a country dominated by blacks.
For more than 300 years, you have been dominated by blacks. You have simply never acknowledged that.
Whether I agree with that statement or not, we must have a say in the future.
If you are talking of anything less than one person, one vote, is a non-negotiable item.
Everything is negotiable.
I am sorry, sir, but what you are proposing is nothing less than a transparent attempt at maintaining the white control.
Mr. Mandela, you are being unduly cynical.
That is a matter of opinion, Mr. President.
Well, we will need to change that. You and I both are going to need to make some changes if this is going to work. We have to set ground rules, but we need to begin negotiations.
Mr. President, I don't mean to flatter you. When I say I sense an integrity here, that has not distinguished you from many of your predecessors. So, yes, I agree.
Go, go, go. Then let's begin.
F.W. de Klerk realizes that he should do everything within his power to let South Africa know that there shall be a new South Africa for all people.
I will be reading a brief statement, but I will be taking no questions at this time. The ban on the National African Congress, the Pan-African Congress, the South African Communist Party, and 33 other organizations will be lifted with immediate effect. And Nelson Mandela will be released in the next few weeks.
have been released from prison. What a day of liberation. Nelson Mandela goes to President de Klerk's office, accusing the South African government of supplying arms to the Inkatha Freedom Party.
How do you expect me to take this talk seriously when people in your government have decided to arm the Inkatha Freedom Party in KwaZulu-Natal?
That is absolute nonsense. To what purpose?
To neutralize the ANC. What else? By intimidation and assignation, your people have given Inkatha carte blanche to create havoc.
Chief Buntelesi has the overwhelming support of the majority of people that live in his province. He does not need me to whip up support for him.
How does it come about so many guns?
How does the ANC have so many guns?
Of course not supplied by your government.
Mr. Mandela, give a man so little room to maneuver.
I have had little room to maneuver myself for 2 decades. One less to adapt.
Those are hard-hitting words one expects to hear from a direct revolutionist.
Mr. President, if you expect me to pasture upon my release, whenever that is, you are greatly mistaken. If I find conditions are exactly the same as they were on the day I was arrested, I will go back to continue to do those things for which I was in prison.
And that will help absolutely no one.
Then unban the ANC and everyone on your panel list. Release political prisoners and let exiles return.
Mr. Mandela, I will take everything that you have said under advisement.
I know, no promises, no promises.
Becomes the first black South African president in history.
Something today. I'm going to now introduce our cast members, which did an amazing job, didn't they, guys? I'm going to first introduce the headliners as Nelson Mandela, Emmanuel Omizaba, and also assistant director as F.W. de Klerk, Bill O'Day. Amazing job. And one of UING's original, Alexis Vandenberg, is Winnie Mandela. Thank you very much. All right, guys, if you'll step back, we're going to now introduce the rest of our cast. Playing the young Nelson Mandela was Sir McClendon. And his mother was Isa McClendon, Officer Isa McClendon. Next, our ceremonial leader was none other than UING Director Jamal Williams. The ceremony elder that held the bowl. The ceremony elder that held the bowl was one of our seniors, Robert Davis. Bob Davis. Talk about. The head of the ANC was our of the executive board was none other than motivational speaker Kevin Burns. Oliver Timbo was none other than Judge Carl Marshall. Next to him, Andrew Malinghini was none other than Mayor and newly Assemblyman Jamil Holly. All right, now we have one of the other prisoners, none other than one of our community people at the Stephen Sampson Center, Mr. Troy Hudson. Longtime friend of the United Youth of New Jersey, and I know a friend of the IRS, Mr. Tim Tucker. Next, one of our original members of the United Youth of New Jersey, I had both of his children in my program, Mr. Darren Williamson, Detective Darren Williamson. Next, we have another member of the United Youth of New Jersey, longtime family member, Hakeem Rashid. Now I'm going to have my little dancers. First of all, I want to introduce our little daughters of Winnie Mandela. We have Jakaya Williams and Natala Destin, which are also dancers. Next we have Nyland Barrett. He's one of our boys. Now, these are all children of UINJ, y'all. Next we have Ja'Kyrie Williams, one of our other boys. Then we have one of our dance choreographers, Nigeria Bracey. Then we have Nairobi Barrett, one of our other dancers. These are all you guys are dancers, y'all. Then we have Jordan Vant. Ayana Vinny. Patience Gary. We have Miana Isaac. Zanaya Isaac. Brianna Radcliffe. Micaiah Robinson. Now I'm going to introduce my seniors who are also our dancers, y'all. We have, and she's a UINJ parent too. Her name is Clooney Civil. She's not one of my seniors, but she's my parent. Next we have Dinah Robinson. Then we have Catherine Mason. Oh no, I'm sorry, Catherine was in a car accident. I'm sorry. So y'all, Catherine Mason was a young lady that was in a car accident. So y'all keep her in prayer, and Sister Tahita Muhammad, keep her in prayer. Next we have Phyllis Wiley. Yvonne David. We have Johnny Gary, one of our grandparents. And I'm going to give it up to these two guys because it was the hardest thing to find two Caucasian police officers, y'all. But I had these two brave men that stepped up to the plate because they realized this is just acting. Okay? I want to introduce some real new good friends of the United Youth of New Jersey. Edgar Lopez and Mario Rodriguez. We have Robert Gary, one of our boys. And then we have Al Tariq Isaac. All right, now I want to introduce Miss Ruthie L. Page, who is our stage director. She was the one behind the scenes, making sure everything happened in a timely fashion. I want y'all to know she worked today. She works for the post office. She worked today and then ran in here and did her job. Ruthie Paige Williams, my girl. That's right. That's right. Her husband corrected me, y'all. And I want you to know we got people sitting outside. We have our alumni sitting out at the table out there. Felicia Brown. That's right. That's my oldest daughter, Felicia Brown. We have Laquan Page, who's also out there. We have two of our alumni in that camera booth up there. They've been taking videos and stuff during the whole show. That's Darlene and Montclair State University and senior. And then we have Mighty Mouse, who's Jessica Curbella. She's a graduate student at Montclair University. Thank you, alumni, for coming back. I'm sorry, Monmouth. Did I say Montclair? I meant Monmouth University. My bad. Okay. All right. Oh, Robin, that's right, Robin Gary. See why I have her here? Robin Gary, also give it up, that's a pair. The directors and the producers of this play is myself, and come on, Mr. Papa, come on out here. Kenny, Mr. Kenny Brown. I want him out here when I say this. Because we just want to say thank you to everyone, but we don't want to forget two important people that also played a very big part. We have Janaea Britt, who's also UINJ alumni. She's a graduate student here at Kane University. There she go. And we also have our amazing, that sexy voice y'all heard on the microphone is none other than Mr. Wayne Avery. Give it up for Wayne. We go back 20 years, y'all. But that is one of the most Barry Whiteness voices I've ever heard in my life. And I have a parent that is an amazing, amazing person. She's been behind the scenes back there. She brought in food this morning, make sure everybody ate. Not only that, she made sure everybody put their clothes on, and was out here in a timely fashion. That's none other than Bianca Vance. Where you at, B? I saved this person for last for a reason. The young person standing right here, holding that camera, is our senior. She's a senior with the United Youth of New Jersey, and she's a senior in high school, and she has been accepted to four colleges, none other than Shania Benny. This young lady has been in film school with the United Youth of New Jersey for 5 years, and I want you to know she's majoring in accounting, and her minor is media, photography. But she has an amazing eye, and she's been videotaping everything from down here, and our alumni have been doing it for up there. And we just want to thank everyone, because I know it snowed this morning. We had a call this morning that was very apologetic from the South African consulate. Yeah, the South African consulate made a call this morning, and they've been very apologetic because they said it's snowing a lot up in New York this morning. So he was not able to be here, but he did tell us he will be in Jersey City on the 22nd. And I am so happy to say that people are excited to see all of your good work. And this was a team effort. This is the biggest cast we've ever had. Ever had. And I am so proud. I am so proud of every last one of them because they all worked very, very hard. And I have never had such an impressive cast. I mean, from the judges, freeholders, mayors. I mean, this is like assemblymen. This is amazing, y'all. I don't know about y'all, but little old us, okay? We must be doing something right, y'all. So on behalf of the United Youth of New Jersey, and we humbly mean this, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for coming out and supporting us. And whenever you see UINJ, oh, wait a minute. First of all, lastly, but not leastly, I want to mention our co-sponsors of this play today, and that's the Pan-African Student Union here at Kane University. Give them a hand. And I don't know if Ty is out there in the audience, but Ty, I thank you because you did an amazing job. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That's the student advisor for the school. And I can't begin to tell you all over again, my amazing mayor. And I say that from the bottom of my heart because I'm one that you gotta prove things to. You can't tell me nothing. You gotta show me. And mayor, you have shown me that you do care. Thank you very much. Y'all have a safe trip home. Be blessed and we'll talk to you soon.
There's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, we don't need escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Picket lines and picket signs, don't punish me with brutality. Sister, talk to me, sister, so you can see, sister, oh, what's going on. Everybody thinks we're wrong. Oh, but who are they to judge us simply cause our hair is long? Oh, you know we've got to find a way. Bring some understanding here today. Oh, oh, oh. Picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Come on, talk to me, so you can see what's going on. Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on. Ooh.
Right, right on. Right on.
Right on.
Yeah.
Right.
Take it home.
my poor little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I must confess that that dream that I had that day has in many points turned into a nightmare.
Every tear from the eye. Yes, I get ready for the revolution. Come on, what you say?